Good morning, everybody. Hope everyone had a great evening. You know, I left here. I went to the hardware store and got some of the stuff that I needed. Got some other running done last night, and I forgot one thing. I guess it's going to stay there until I leave today. Dang it. Oh, well. Let's see. Where'd I leave off last night? I got to do some rust repair there. I believe that's the last of the rust back here. And one of my other customers came in yesterday, the one with the AAR CUDA. He said he has the exact same car. It's 68, 383 car. That he's wanting done up as well. And he bought another shell from out west to get parts off of. He said he's got this firewall in this fender section. So I'm gonna hold off on doing that until he sees exactly what all he's got. Because it would be nice to be able to just use the factory panel put right back in there. All right. Well, let me finish getting opened up. I got to get the air on and things like that. And then we'll see if we can't get some work done today. That's what I was afraid of. Alright, I'm gonna have to find me either a little bitty cutoff wheel or something, because I don't want to cut through the... Well, it's not another brace. I thought it was. Let's see if this will. Why in the heck don't I have any air pressure? I bet I didn't turn the air on. Now that the air's built up. Really? When trying to weld, you don't want it on grind mode.
Thank you. Thank you.
if you guys remember, I took all that Bondo off of here. I wanted to see what was under it. Some pitting, some dents, stuff like that. So I went ahead and glazed it back on there. I had to check it, make sure there wasn't nothing, no holes or nothing like that. Now it's time to sand it. happy with this area here. This area is kind of tough to do with the air tools, so I'm just gonna glaze it back in and do it by hand. Same way with this area. Starting to harden up on me, guys. Yeah. Oh, well. All right. I gotta run down to the hardware store real quick. Then I'll get back. I'll hand sand that along that back window right there. And I believe all the body work, well, I ended up glazing this back section one more time. Same thing, hard to do with the power tools, so I'm gonna do that by hand. Hit those few spots, and then I think I'm gonna put 220 on the DA and go over the whole body. I'll get a hold of my customer that said he has parts and see about getting the firewall section. All right, guys, I got my running done. Had to go to the hardware store yesterday. The lock on the front door acted up on me. And it's not like your house locks. It's a little bit different. Had to take it apart, take it down to the hardware store, and the guys down there rebuilt it for me and rekeyed it for me. So yeah, all good to go now. I wanted to change the keys anyways. That's all right. I come back, put it together, and took me a minute to figure out how. Gonna be honest, I've never done them kind of locks before. But now I've got the idea how they're supposed to work. If I ever do another one, I don't know. I was gonna call a locksmith out of Pickwood to come up and fix it, but minimum $200 by the time you're done. And yeah, I took it down there with tax and everything. It was $10.70, so I cannot complain on that. I can, however, complain that I didn't get to do this power. Manual labor, come on now. That's okay, though. I'll get it handled. I'm gonna have to get some supplies
I'm thinking by the end of the week I should be able to have this thing ready for primer. Well, front inner fenders and the firewall area, not so much, but the rest of it should be ready. How many of you is going on the power tour? Leave it in the comments if you're going on the power tour next week. And if you are, what are you taking? You know the power tour is only 40 miles from here. You'll be going from Columbus to Indy. When you get to I-75, I'm about 35, 40 miles north of that. As much as I wanted to go, it's not gonna happen. Don't have the cash for that. Just don't have the cash for that. I think I'm gonna grab a different block for that up there. There's multiple curves. Picked these up at a garage sale. Guy had all kinds of different sanding blocks. He did a, what was that, a 3940 Ford, something like that. He bought all the blocks that he wanted, and when the job was done, he sold everything at a garage sale. Bought it all. Funny thing is, got to talking with him, and he knows my dad. Speaking of him, he's pulling in right now. He knows my dad and said, "Hey, your dad's got that 39 Ford Rumble seat." I said, "Yeah." He said, "I got something for him." He come out with the convertible top mechanism for it. This is coming out beautiful. Hi, Pop. Yeah. As soon as I get the money, I'm getting rid of this hoist, putting a four post in. This thing is annoying. I've gone through two bags of floor dry trying to keep that clean. Yeah, maybe next year I'll go on the Hot Rod Power Tour. But I know it won't be as close to me as it is this year. Who knows what I'll take? I don't have something else going by then, y'all know what it'll be. At least you should know. And if you don't, throw a couple guesses out there. That feels a lot better. Should have grabbed this block before. All right, that feels pretty decent. I think I'm gonna go ahead and call her a day. Think I'm gonna run and get some floor dry, because it's chasing me. It's trying to get me. Oh well. Well guys, I'm gonna get out of here. I'll sand on this in the morning. I gotta call and get some prices on some materials. And hopefully we can see some primer on this thing pretty soon. That would be nice. All right, guys, till tomorrow, have a blessed evening.